What's your first basketball memory, Eric?
I guess my first basketball memory is when my father was coaching at Ashland College in Ohio, and I would just go to practice with him and hang out. And he had an old pregame warm-up that was like no other, where guys were spinning balls and people were on unicycles, and the gym was rocking. And then he went from Ashland to the University of Minnesota. And I would say that, you know, I vividly remember going to school in Bloomington, Minnesota, and then after school asking my mom to please take me down to Williams Arena so that I could go hang out. And, originally I thought I would go watch the 3 o'clock practice that would end at 5. And at that time there was not time limits on practice, and practice really went from about 3 to 7. And then my dad would watch film, and I'd get home at 10:30 as a fourth grader. But I wanted to do it day after day after day, and my dad was my idol, and I wanted to follow in his footsteps since the day that I can remember.
And then, I mean, just your stops from Rapid City to, you know, the NBA, Orlando and Atlanta's assistant. You had 2 years with the Golden State Warriors, the Memphis Grizzlies, Kings. This is not your first rodeo in Reno. I mean, we could go on and on and on here. But the reason why I bring this up is that, you know, here you are in 2018 with this moment. And I'd love to just let fans understand what it's like to be a lifer and go on this basketball journey and be able to enjoy it the way that you have here, Coach.
Well, yeah, I mean, obviously, Rich, people, you know, I think people see, you know, last night, you know, how excited I was after the game and how excited I am in the locker room and with my, you know, my players. And to me, it's just been an incredible journey. I mean, I got a great opportunity to be a head coach at a really young age of two teams. Made a career decision when I got let go by the Kings that I wanted to be a dad. I had two sons that I, felt like I hadn't been around them enough. So I was a dad for 3 years. I sat in carpool lane, sipping a Starbucks coffee. And one day, while I was in carpool lane, after 3 years, I said, I got to get back to coaching. And I went to the D League and did that for 2 years and didn't get an NBA call up, so to speak, as a coach. And we had two really, really great D League seasons. And I made a decision to go, into college basketball. And I knew what I didn't know. And I had to put my ego aside. I had to ask for my family's blessing to go be a college assistant. Spent 2 years at Arizona State and then a year at LSU. And really, Rich, the year at LSU was a defining moment because Flip Saunders had called, and Flip had played for my dad. And he had offered me a job with the Timberwolves. And when I passed that up to go to LSU and work for Johnny Jones, who was someone that I had no prior relationship, you know, my family was all in on the college experience, and I'm so glad I did it. And so really the 3 years of being an assistant let me have time to sit back and look at the recruiting landscape and to try to come up with a game plan when I was lucky or fortunate enough to get a head job.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.